Hello my little cutie and welcome to my video. So as you can see by the title, this is my favourites video for the months of September and October. Well, I can't believe we're actually near the end of the year. I've actually got a mixture of makeup and beauty products as well as some really random stuff because I don't want this just to be all about makeup. I want it to be about fun stuff as well. But if you want to see what my favourites are, then please keep on watching. So yeah, just a side note, my voice does sound quite deep today, and that is because it was Halloween yesterday. So yeah, you can see what's happened, Halloween parties and all that jazz. So yes, let's try and move on from that. So first thing is something that I've been quite obsessed with lately, and I'm sure you probably have seen it around if you're in America. I'm not sure if it's sold in other countries, but it's actually just come out in the UK, I believe, and that is Smart Water. Okay, so the first time I actually tried this was near enough 3 years ago now when I went to Disney World, Florida. And I got this and I really, really liked it. It just tastes so fresh and it does actually taste quite crisp. It does say on here, clean, crisp taste, and it does taste like that. Need to try a normal bottle of water, tap water, and this, and you would definitely see a difference. I love it so much. Thank you for bringing it out in the UK. Yay! Now I've seen it, I'm gonna have to have some. And as always, I always drink for a straw. Next product is the Garnier Express 2-in-1 Makeup Remover. So it's ultra efficient and it protects eyelashes. All I do is I pop this on a cotton pad and I literally hold it on my eye for about 10 seconds and then I just swipe away like this and it's gone and it's on the pad. Wow. So if you do wear quite a lot of eye makeup, I really do recommend this because it doesn't take long to take your makeup off. But it is actually an eye makeup remover and it takes off all like your mascara. I just rub it like this as well with a cotton pad and it gets all your mascara off. And afterwards as well, it does actually make your eye area feel really soft. I think in the UK this is about, I think it's around £3, £4. But yeah, that's lasted me quite a while. Next favourite is, okay, so I've been trying, I've been changing up my foundation routine a little bit. When I apply my concealer, I did used to use like a setting powder with my Real Techniques brush as normal, dab it on. But I was looking through all my makeup, I recently discovered this. Here we go. So this is the MUA Matte Perfect Loose Powder. Translucent, this is in the shade. And I bought quite a lot of MUA stuff ages ago. And I don't know, I used it for a while, but then I just kind of put it to the back of my makeup and then I started using more high-end stuff. But this is actually really good and it's so affordable. So what I do is it's quite like, looks like that. So I just shake a bit in there and I've actually been using a let me show you. I've been using the MAC 109 contour brush to actually set that. So I just dab it in here and just pat it under my eye area. And I found that this works so well because it covers all that eye area, and because it is loose powder, it's not like you're putting loads on, you're actually spreading it out on this brush as well. If you see what I mean. I'm really going to try and find another one that's a bit more lighter, just so it highlights that under area as well. So if you've got any recommendations for a good loose powder, then please let me know in the comments below. So next favourite is actually a few favourites in one. I've been loving mixing a lip liner and a lipstick and a lip gloss. There's four options I've been using quite a lot within the last 2 months. So the first one that I've been loving and I've actually been wearing quite a lot recently is this sleek makeup. This is the Ooh La La liner and it's in the shade Melba and it's a really nice peachy orangey colour. So I've been applying this on its own, that looks really nice, but to tone it down a little bit I've been using Myth by MAC and it's actually what I'm wearing on my lips today. I actually do like peachy colours for autumn just because it's like the autumn leaves and stuff like that, peachy golds and stuff. So if you've got them, give them a little mix and see what you think. So the next one is a NYX lip liner, and this is in the shade Nude, and it's the retractable lip liner. So I've been wearing this as well. On its own looks great and nice and natural, but I've been actually mixing it with the shade Pure Zen by MAC. This is quite pinky, whereas this is more nude, and that mixed together is really, really nice. So that's quite natural. So if you're going for a really bold, smoky look and you want to go for a nice nudie lip. The next one is, I've been using MAC lip liner Hip and Happy. So it's a really nice pinky colour, almost like a Barbie colour. So I've been applying that. On its own, it's really good. And actually, the MAC lip liners last for ages. It's kind of like it almost stains your lips, that's why it lasts so long. So I really do recommend MAC lip liners. So yeah, I've been using that mixed with MAC Cream Cup. This is an absolute beautiful lipstick, one of my favourites recently. I actually just like mainly wearing them two on its own, but sometimes I have gone to use the Colour Your Smile by Gerard Cosmetics, the Sugar Mama lip gloss. And this is a really Barbie pinky colour. I suppose it's more of a pop of colour rather than a naturally nude colour. And last but not least, the next one that I've been loving is Boldly Bare Lip Liner, again by MAC. So that's more of a brownie, warm tone colour. That mixed with this new lipstick that I actually got, and it's the shade Brave. It's similar in the shade. Again, it's quite of a warm brown colour. And on top of that, I've been using Colour Your Smile Gerard Cosmetics Buttercream Lip Gloss. It tones the colour down a little bit because it has got a slight pinky colour in. That's all of the lipsticks and lip liners and lip glosses that I've been loving. So if you have any suggestions, then again, just comment below. And yes, so they're my four favourites, and this is probably my most favourite. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this is actually a really random one, but I really want to just tell you how much I've been liking it. It's a air freshener for your car. This is the Febreze Fresh Escapes, and this is the Open Sky fragrance. It's like really fresh, and you pop it in on your, what's it called, your blower thing, your heat thing. Air conditioning. Yeah, you pop it on there and it just Febrezes all your car. Random, I know, but you know, if you're looking for a new car freshener, try this. Okay, so the next one is something that I don't really see many people talk about, but I'm really interested in it because I really want to know what people actually do. Okay, let me explain. So here is the Nair Facial Wax Strips. It actually includes 20 Argan Oil Wax Strips, 2 Calming Pre-Wipes and 2 Moisturising Post-Wipes. I use this to basically wax my upper lip. I used to actually use Nair Hair Removal, but it really got to a point where it started to get quite irritating to my skin, so I thought I need to try something different. So this actually got recommended that I use the Nair Facial Wax Strips. I was really cautious at first because I've never actually waxed my face before on my own, but I thought, okay, I'll give it a go. And because it has argan oil in, I thought, why not? And it's actually suitable for dry and sensitive skin. I have really sensitive skin, so I thought, yeah, I'll give it a go. And literally, it was the most easiest thing in the world. So first thing is, it has wipes in the packet. And this is a pre-waxing wipe. This actually cleanses the skin, so I just put it on the area, wait for it to dry a little bit, and then I use the wax strips. And there's quite a lot of wax strips that come in the packet. Yeah, you have to heat it up in your hands, pop it on, and then just pull it off. And it didn't actually hurt at all. And then after you've done that, just to get away any more wax that's been left on the area, you just use a post-waxing wipe. It was really, you could actually feel the argan oil on there. It was nice and smooth and it felt really refreshing. And there wasn't any stinging, there wasn't any blood, there wasn't any burning, there wasn't any redness. It was just like I didn't do anything. So I really do recommend waxing, and especially with these, with the argan oil, give them a try. Okay, so I want to give a little shout out to my little baby, and this is a Clarisonic. This is the Clarisonic Mia 2 in the shade pink. It basically removes like all your makeup and it cleanses all your face and really gives it a nice deep wash. I got this as a Christmas present last Christmas, which I think is a really good idea. So if you are looking for one of these, ask for it from Santa. You know, why not? And it was the best present I ever got because it's actually really like changed my skin, and I can't explain to you how it feels after you use it. It's like, oh, it's so heaven. It feels really fresh and it feels like it does actually go deep into your pores and gets all that dirt out. When you buy this, it actually comes with like a normal, I think it's a normal head thing. And when I first got it, I was using it every morning and every evening, and it made my skin quite worse. It like made me have spots and it's quite red, and it's because I was using it too much, and because I have sensitive skin anyway, the brush head was quite rough for my skin. So I purchased the sensitive one, and I do recommend you try that as well if you're having problems, because it's so soft. I take my makeup off like with my eye makeup remover and then some like wipes, and then I use this. Some people do actually put this straight on their face without taking any makeup off. I don't like doing that. I did try it, but I found that it actually made this really dirty, and the thought of all the bacteria, even more bacteria on this, just kind of freaked me out. So that's why I just take my makeup off first. As I said, it makes your skin feel so nice. It does. It's like you've just, I don't know, like been to a spa or something, and you just feel really nice and refreshed. So I do recommend this. Invest in one of these because it is really good, and there is quite a lot of people on YouTube that have done so many reviews about it. So read the reviews first and see if it is actually right for you before you go and purchase it. But there is quite a lot of companies now that are doing like cleansing brushes similar to this. I think Clinique's just brought a similar one out, and before I had this I tried the number 7 one. So if you don't want to pay the price, because I know it is really expensive, you can try a more affordable version to see if you can get on with it, and then go for this. Like I said, maybe ask Santa to get you one. You never know, his little elves could easily make you one. So lastly, I just want to give a little mention to a MAC blusher that I've been loving, and it's in the shade Melba. This is the powder blush. It's quite of a nice peachy warm colour. On camera it looks quite pink, but it's actually not. It's more of a browny peachy colour. I'm wearing this on my cheeks today, and like I said, I've been loving peachy stuff recently. I'll give you a little, I don't think you'll be able to see. I've actually been wearing it on days with just blusher, no like bronzer or contouring, and it looks really nice. I'm sure it'll actually suit all skin types as well, so give that a go. Melba by MAC. Yeah, so I actually think that's the end of my favourites video. There is quite a variety of stuff. I did try and mix up a little bit. There is quite a lot of stuff I have been loving, but I do want to put too much in the video. As always, please let me know what your favourites are and comment that down below. Please check out my other videos, and yes, give it a big thumbs up. Thank you for the support, and I shall see you in my next video. Bye!